Good morning everyone, am I audible? So I'll be talking about introduction to Sunbird. Sunbird is a platform that we'll get to know in a bit. But before that, I'd like to, you know, do a quick analysis about you guys. Although your introduction session is scheduled to happen sometime later in the day. But I just want to know a quick few things. How many of you are from second year of your in degree? Okay, so like you are in second year, or you have completed your second year and now completed, so you are now going to your third year. And how many of you are in your third year? Okay, so you have completed your third year and this is your industrial training break. Okay, how many of you are from computer science background? Majority. Is there any who is from some other stream like electronics and telecommunication or some? Because
I'm from ICT.
ICT, what is it?
Information and Communication.
Okay, it's more or less the same. And how many of you have worked on any of the open source projects before? Have you contributed to any open source project? You. Which project was it?
Actually, it was Kaltura.
Mm-hmm. That's great. Okay, nice to know. Anyone else? No. How many of you are aware that what are open source projects? What is this thing, open source? Because in your next 8 weeks, you'll hear it more often. Okay, so not many of you are aware about open source projects. I'll briefly talk about it. I have a different slides ready because in the past I have given a session on what is an open source project and how to contribute to it. So if anyone of you need those slides, just drop a mail to me. How many of you have worked with GitHub and you are aware of this version control system, Git? That's okay, there are many. Good. And how many of you are aware about the agile development model of software development model? Not many. Okay, so in your courses it's still iterative waterfall model that is being taught, is it? Or it is not yet covered in your engineering? It's okay, so it may be a part of your syllabus in your upcoming years. Okay, this is definitely you should check what is the agile software development model, because it's being used so much in the industry these days. All right, then let's begin with the presentation. Okay, introduction to Sunbird. We'll briefly look at all these contents. I have not many slides. I have only a few slides, so I'll wind up early. So we'll begin with understanding what is Eight-Step Foundation, then idea behind Eight-Step, Eight-Step platform, Sunbird platform, the Genie app, what's in the store for you, and resources. So Eight-Step Foundation is a not-for-profit foundation which is co-founded by one of the alumnus of IIT Bombay, and he is Mr. Nandan Neelkeni, and Ms. Rohini Neelkeni, and Mr. Shankar Maruwada. Now, when anyone starts an organization, there is an idea behind that, there is a purpose, there is a reason, or there is some problem that they are trying to solve. So the problem that the Eight-Step Foundation is trying to solve is that in India, particularly in the rural setting, there is lack of access to learning opportunities, and it's a very complex and multidimensional problem. See, we are fortunate, I think most of us are fortunate to have receive a very good education, but if you go to the rural settings, the people are not that privileged. So there are some initiatives by the government of India in order to help resolve this problem, and there are some noble people, benevolent people who come up with such foundations. And you will wonder that almost 200 million children in India are affected by these problems. So this is the problem which is impacting the lives of millions of children on a daily basis. So this is the problem that they are trying to solve. So how they are trying to solve? They've created an Eight-Step platform, which is a platform to create, share, and distribute free community sourced educational content for primary school children. So it is mainly targeted for the school students, for the primary school children. And what's a Sunbird platform? Sunbird is an open source platform developed by Eight Step Foundation and is licensed under AGPL license. Sunbird is open source. Again, this term open source. It is configurable, it is extendable, it is a modular learning management platform. What's Genie? Genie gives you access to free educational content from the Eight Step platform. The content which was created, which is being created on the Eight Step platform, is being accessed through Genie mobile app. It's an Android app. So with Genie, you can explore and download free educational content. You can create and manage multiple user profiles. You can consume interactive audio video content. Use the app in currently in these three languages, English, Hindi, and Kannada. The other languages are being worked upon, and get recommendations for content best suited for you as a user. So I know these three slides, still the picture is not very clear. So, because to me also, while making these three slides, it was not clear. So I decided to make this diagram. So I think it will be more clearer to you now. So Eight Step platform is an initiative by the Eight Step Foundation. Okay, as you can see, and Eight Step platform is the front end, and on the behind, it's the Sunbird platform. So Sunbird platform gives the entire functionality to the Eight Step platform. Okay, on Eight Step platform, the teachers, tutors, everyone who, any citizen who would like to create lessons for school students, enroll on Eight Step platform and be a creator. There are also other roles, like you can also be a reviewer of that content, and there are many such other roles. So that's how people contribute on Eight Step platform. And the consumers, who are the students, now how do they access that? So they access that through an Android application, which is the Genie app. Okay, its beta version is available to download on the Google Play Store. So what's Sunbird for you? Like, what's in the store for you? So it's an opportunity, I'll say, because this project is very new. It's only an year or two old, and some of the best teams in India are working on this project, and we are fortunate that some exploratory work and some extension to the existing functionality of Sunbird is being worked upon here. So many of the project proposals will revolve around Sunbird. So you can contribute to it if you are a software developer by writing code to develop new features or enhance the existing features. You can contribute as software architects by extending the platform architecture. As educators, I think we don't have such audience here, but if you are a teacher or an educator, you can contribute to it by suggesting courses, course structures, creating learning materials, reviewing artifacts, and more. And lastly, as students, using the learning artifacts and providing feedback. Now, resources. I'll quickly glance through you the website of Sunbird so that you know where you need to get started. I want you to, those of you are starting to getting interest in this, I want you to note these three URLs. First is sunbird.org, another is eightstep.org, eightstep.in. I think you can even memorize it. They are pretty simple. Sunbird.org, eightstep.org, and eightstep.in. So this is the Sunbird website, which talks about Sunbird. I'm really impressed by the way they have documented this entire project, considering the fact that it's only 1 year old. But since it's an open source project, and an open source project is the project wherein people contribute to it, right? So in order for people to understand that, where should we contribute, they need to understand the software first. And how they will understand? they will go through the documentation, and if the documentation is good, they'll be able to contribute to it in a much more productive way. So they've documented it pretty well. If you go to the developer documentation, you can see on the left they started with an architecture diagram, because defining an architecture is one of the primary stages of a software development. So after the presentation, or whenever you will explore your project proposals, so you can go through these documentations. Okay, so here in the architecture, you will get all those details about the architecture. Then in the developer documentation, if you'll go, you will get to see how to get started with the Sunbird. Here in the installation, there are different type of installations of Sunbird. This one is to install on your single machine. This deployment is up to is for up to 10,000 users, and when we say it's scalable beyond 10,000 users also, if it's deployed in such a way. You will also, one of the projects will also talk about, you know, deploying it using containerization using Docker. One of our colleagues will be presenting the same shortly. So it will be a good learning. Then contribute to Sunbird. You will also see here how you can contribute through code. There are guidelines how you can contribute to the documentation, existing documentation of Sunbird. One of the myths is that open source software projects, people can only contribute to them through writing code, but it's not like that. Even if there is a small typo error in their documents, which is totally, you know, removing the sense of it, then you can raise a pull request using you can also report that, and that will also be counted as a contribution to that open source project. We'll quickly look at the tech stack. So this is the tech stack of Sunbird. In the background, they have used AngularJS, Java Play, Apache Cassandra, Elasticsearch, Docker again for containerization of some Sunbird components. Okay. These are primarily the components of Sunbird: Sunbird Portal, Content Editor Plugins, Sunbird Services, and others. Okay, so this was one of the URLs. The other URL was akestep.in. So this is the one where in all the tutors, teachers come and create lessons. When you go to lessons, you can see till date there are around 6,068 lessons already being created. Okay, you can search them through different filters. These are trivial things. I should not be sharing this with you, but this is self-exploratory. You can go through this URL, and using your Google or Facebook account, when you log in, you'll also have a privilege to create lessons into it. Okay, so, and these lessons which you create here, the consumer will consume it through Genie app. Yeah. So currently only 3 languages are supported by the Genie app. So maybe this can be one of your contributions, that you can give support for other languages. Okay. So this is briefly, as promised, I'll wind it up in just a minute. So majority of the resources you'll find on this website, sunbird.org/docs. Okay. And these are some of the references, and thank you.